We are in Milan today, in the kitchen of Giallo Zafferano, to prepare an evergreen of Lombardy cuisine, the Milanese steak, a dish everyone likes.
Quindi, preparem la cotoletta alla milanese.
In order to prepare the Milanese steak, we will need veal loin, clarified butter, grated bread, eggs, salt and a bit of molten salt. Let's cut the meat. The steak must be cut a bit thick as to get a classical cut. I'll slice two. Average weight of each steak is about 250 grams. It is a fair amount of meat, although you have to consider that it also includes the bone. The bit of the bone, where all the nerves are, it's going to release during cooking a very interesting taste, round and full. Now I'm going to clean the bone from all this extra flesh, which otherwise during cooking would become brown.
Marroncine, così poi
whereas like this, the butter will make the whole bone bit beautifully clear.
Ecco qua.
Here it is. Let's take everything off nicely. Let's put aside all the waste. And let's do also the other steak.
Raspiamo bene.
Let's scrape it properly like this. Let's also try to reduce the bit of the bone. So that it will cook faster and better. So here, let's get rid of this little bit. Please be careful with the knives and bear in mind it's always better to have properly sharpened knives. Because they help cut better, and consequently, they don't slip, and they are less likely to cut you. So have your knives properly sharpened. Now I'm going to pound the meat only to make it homogeneous. So a very, very light pounding. I'll get rid of the superficial nerves that during cooking might make the steak shrink. And here, we have two steaks ready to be buttered. Here we are. Perfect. So let's butter our steaks now. Let's crack two eggs in a big bowl. Without breaking the yolk too much. The two eggs should preferably be fresh, okay? Then we put the bread in a broad and large dish. Do not put salt nor flour on the steak, because salt would dehydrate the meat, would produce a liquid film around it and would prevent the bread from sticking on it. Not even flour, because the flour would then fall off during cooking. So let's dredge it once, and then, using the bone as a handle to move the steak from one thing to the other,
come mezzo per trasportare la costoletta da una parte all'altra e facciamo questa operazione.
Pressiamo carefully, bene, squeezing it.
Vedete? In questa maniera.
Like this.
E una
and
seconda,
then again, the second drenching.
Andiamo.
You need to squeeze very accurately the meat without flattening it too much. There are several different ways to make a Milanese steak. I'm making it thick, which is the one I like most, because I like savoring the meat's taste rather than the crispy fried bread. But also the thinner one, which children like a lot, My daughter, for instance, who is 28, still eats the thinner one because that's the one she likes. So I cook it both ways. The choice is yours. Okay, let's start again with the second one. When preparing the Milanese steak, you must remember to sing Oh My Beautiful Little Madonna.
That's it.
In order to make the bread stick to the meat more, we are going to pound it with a carving knife. And here, we have made the thick Milanese steak. Now, if you wish, you could slice the steak across in two and open it wide by pounding it. You could make the so-called elephant ear, which is a big Milanese steak, with a bone in the middle and the two famous elephant ears on the sides. That's very nice too, but has to be soaked thin. Let's draw some lines like this. If you make a Milanese, the butter is very important. Should be prepared very close to preparation and cooking so that the bread doesn't get done. If you don't have enough time and need to make it in advance, remember to give it another layer of grated bread before cooking it. It will dry the humidity and the butter will result crispier. Now let's move to the preparation of the potatoes. We need ratty potatoes, clarified butter, rosemary, garlic, salt and a little bit of pepper. Let's take the ratty potatoes. The ratty potatoes are small new potatoes that you don't need to peel, as it would produce a lot of waste. You simply have to wash them properly in some water and baking soda. They are very useful because they cook extremely quickly. We slice them with this mandolin slicer. Mind your fingers. And we put them in some water to avoid oxidation. Let's slice them, keeping the middle part and chucking the two ends. Let's store them in water a little bit. They lose some of their starch, even if the ratty potato is not that full of starch. Then we drain them a bit and dip them in a casserole full of salty boiling water to blanch them. Leave them to boil. They will cook a little and then we will proceed cooking them either in oil or in butter as we prefer. The potatoes boiled for about 1-1.5 minutes. Let's drain them. Here I'm going to cool them down a bit. And then I'll dry them with a tea towel to prevent spluttering when dipped in the hot clarified butter. Let's move to cooking. Let's increase the temperature. The pan must be fairly hot. Let's add the clarified butter. If you don't want to use butter, you can easily use extra virgin oil. It doesn't change much. It is only slightly more sour. I prefer butter because we have the two tastes in the steak and in the potatoes that match. While cooking the potatoes, we can also start preparing to cook the Milanese steaks. In this case, the butter must be abundant. We are not deep frying, but still, it has to be rich in fat. The clarified butter for the potatoes is already hot enough so that we can stir fry them nicely, okay? Let's add a garlic clove. If you like to have this flavor, but only cutting it and leaving it unpeeled.
un pochino di rosmarino,
bit of rosemary to give it a nice smell,
un bel profumo, e avremo una cottura vivace
and consistent
e continua, quindi come se fosse una specie di frittura, eh? Anzi,
in fact, if you have a frying machine
e volete cuocere nell'olio, potete friggere direttamente. La patata,
the stir-fry potato is the typical side dish for the Milanese steak. Let's dip in the clarified butter
le cotolette,
the steaks
dalla parte
on the lined side.
Della rigatura. Il burro deve essere
the butter
caldo,
must be hot,
ma non
but not intensely,
perché
because
non
it must
deve
not immediately fry, otherwise the inside cooking
la internamente non
won't be perfectly
perfetta,
even.
Quindi,
so, good temperature,
una bella temperatura,
but not extreme,
ma non esagerata, eh? La patata ratta,
the rata potato absorbs a very little fat, so it is also lighter. Let's now turn the steak.
La costoletta,
it's nicely golden colored.
E anche le
and also the lines are beautifully vivid.
Livide. Col cucchiaio,
scoop with your spoon some of the cooking fat
grasso di cottura, e
and pour it on the bone handle
sul manico dell'osso in, modo
in order
tale
to
da
make it a nice light color.
Un bel colore chiaro e non vedere più quelle striature.
Uncover
del,
those blood
del
streaks,
che erano ancora
which were still a bit too intense.
Intense. Molto bene.
Very well.
La cottura durerà
cooking
circa
time's about 8 minutes, which is the same time required by the potatoes to
il
cook.
Il tempo necessario anche per cucinare le patate.
So we get to cook both things at the same time
quasi
and reach the maximum result.
Ed avere il massimo dell'espressione perché la fragranza
because
è
fragrance is the key element of this dish.
La riuscita di questo piatto. Panatura aderente.
Firm butter.
Rosolatura.
Perfect sauté. Also the lines are very nice.
Patate croccanti.
Crispy potatoes. The inside must be slightly pink.
Rosata,
not too well done. To be more juicy.
Ultimo tocco.
Last touch. Remember we never put salt. Let's put some molten salt, which is in flakes.
Abbondante.
A lot. To give a lot of taste to the meat. The meat inside would be very sweet. We're looking at a masterpiece of the Milanese cuisine, an absolute dish. A dish that, thanks to my suggestions, you'll be able to prepare at home as a great chef.